Hi, I'm Jochem, an engineer at Tameson, and today we're going to talk about bearing lubrication. Good lubrication extends the lifespan by reducing friction and preventing corrosion. Lubricants can be divided into three types: grease, oil-based, and dry lubricants. Of these, oil and grease are most commonly used in bearings. The right choice depends on many different factors. Usually, the bearing manufacturer states the right lubricant to use in the bearing manual. One of the most important parameters in choosing a lubricant is its viscosity. A high viscosity increases friction but also ensures that the lubricant will continue to do its job for a longer period of time and therefore requires less maintenance. The choice of viscosity depends on the speed and load. For a low speed and a high load, a lubricant with a high viscosity is advised. To get you started with the selection, I will briefly explain all three lubricants. Bearing grease is the most commonly used type of lubricant. It adheres well to the surface, has a long lifespan, and compared to oil, is more likely to stay in place and not leak. In addition, in some applications, pre-lubricating with bearing grease can eliminate the need for occasional maintenance or a lubrication system. Bearing oil is usually used when heat needs to be removed from the surface of the bearing due to high speed or high temperature. However, it is more susceptible to leakage, which can cause damage to mechanical parts. The oil should be constantly checked to maintain the correct level. Dry lubricants are mainly used in areas where grease or oil are not an option. Dry lubricants reduce friction between bearing surfaces. They do not require or use oil or grease during operation. Usually, bearings that use dry lubricants come pre-lubricated. Dry lubricants offer many advantages over grease or oil, including less friction and wear on parts, less heat generation, longer bearing life, and it doesn't attract dirt. However, dry lubricants are more expensive and require more frequent maintenance. As a result, it is often not a cost-effective solution. If you need more help selecting the right bearing lubrication, please check out the technical article on our website, tameson.com. If you found this a useful video, hit the like button and subscribe for more videos. If you have any more questions, drop them below the video or contact me or anyone else from Tameson.